word into particular people's lives. As you're listening to me today, the Lord Jesus will begin to speak to you certain things that you need to hear. My assignment is whole person prosperity. I can make you rich. You say, Bob, you really can make me rich materially? Well, my job is to make you rich in faith. The Lord Jesus Christ, though He was rich, yet for your sake He became poor so you could be rich, abundantly supplied in every area of your life. Stay tuned. You're going to find out how you too can go into business with God and begin to prosper in every area of your life.
Welcome to Success in Life International with Robert Tilton, home of whole person prosperity, dedicated to your spiritual, physical, and financial well-being. How to have more life for living, a better life, see your dreams and desires of your heart come true. Learn how to live the rich, full, and abundant life in Christ, that your days may be as the days of heaven on earth, today and forever. And now live and rebroadcast across America and around the world is author, entrepreneur, pastor, and modern-day prophet of success and divine prosperity with the new Success in Life television network is Robert Tilton.
Just as the Apostle Paul said, "But my God shall supply all of your need according to His riches in glory." There are riches in glory, riches in heaven. The wealth of heaven is at our disposal. He said, "My God shall supply all your need according to your riches in glory through Jesus Christ." The power of using the name of Jesus to draw our riches out of glory. People are not perishing because of lack of money. People are perishing because of lack of knowledge, lack of vision, and lack of putting the Word of God to work into their lives. We're here to help you get out of the box. Peter saw Christ. He had a vision. He saw Jesus walking on the water, doing the impossible. And Peter asked the Lord, "Can I come out there also?" And Jesus said, "Come on out here." Peter became inspired. He saw what he could do in Jesus, and he stepped out of the boat. He stepped out of the box. He stepped out of the limited life in himself, and he stepped into the abundant life in Christ. There is abundance in glory. Jesus told us this. He said, "Hitherto have you asked nothing in my name. Ask so that your joy may be full." He says, "Whatever you ask in my name," he said, "I will do it, that the Father will be glorified in the Son." He gave us the authority to use His name out of His account. We're not drawing out of what we have and whatever's in our account, but we're going to the bank of heaven to draw out of our heavenly account. Coming up is a precious couple who watched me on television, and they had a revelation that they had been eating their seed instead of planting it. When they began to watch me, they discovered the wow of the vow. And listen closely, they went into business with God. You realize that you too can go into business with God? I'm going to talk more about that because we're doing some wonderful, exciting things on the new Success in Life broadcast. Now watch this testimonial. Let it build your faith, because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. Listen, because God will spark fire in your being. You will hear a rhema word. You'll have a revelation knowledge. And like Peter, you can step out of the box where you are into the unlimited life in Christ. Watch this, and I'll be back to talk some more about how you can prosper in every area of your life.
God says, you know, He will give seed to the sower, and He will give bread for us to eat, and He will multiply our seed sown.
Offer unto God thanksgiving. Make your vows, pay your vows, and He'll deliver you in the day of trouble.
You gotta have vows with God, and then it releases the blessings from heaven into your hands, spiritually and financially. Rather than alive and excited about life, it was like just another day. Well, here's another day again, we got bills to pay, and that's it, that's our life. That's my portion of life, just bills.
You know, our self-image was, you know, deteriorated bad. We didn't believe, wow, could we ever get to zero? I mean, we were in debt. You know, how can we get to broke?
Like many newlyweds, Rosemarie and Glenn's beginning years of marriage were tarnished by accumulated debt.
We were tithers, however, sometimes sporadic. When we first got married, my wife didn't want to do it. She says, no, your income isn't paying our bills. How can you do this too?
Then one day, Rosemarie happened upon Success in Life.
And he was talking about the widow woman, and she had a last meal. She was going to eat it, and she was going to die. And then the prophet, Elijah, he talked to her. He said, if you make me a meal first, your meal barrel will not be dry. And when he said it, the presence of God just filled the room. I knew that the Lord spoke to me about making a vow. I will have to step out of the circumstance and trust him. And that I wanted to make a vow of $100. Now, at the time, $100 was a lot, but I obeyed the Lord. And all we had at that time was $12, just our last $12. So it was either I hold on to $12 and die, or I give it. And I told Glenn, my husband, about it when he came home, and we wrote a check out. We went to the mailbox and we put it.
They gave their last $12 believing God would deliver them, and they needed it because their car was to be repossessed the next day. After they mailed their vow payment, Glenn took Rosemarie to a job interview.
And she walked in, it was just to be an interview, and they usually find out weeks later whether they've got the job. Well, they hired her instantly, and she had got the job. And also $1,000 came into our hands the next day, and that took care of that crisis right then. And we also paid the $88 remaining on the vow. Okay, immediately I was high in faith, and I made immediate vow for $1,000 right then, because that wasn't the end of all our problems, and we wanted to be prosperous. We wanted the life that Bob was talking about. We could live above and not beneath. All of a sudden, we just had an inner peace because we were in faith. We had paid a vow, and we knew we were going to continue. We knew it was going to be a part of our life. So at that time, in a matter of 2 weeks, our business multiplied. I had 10 people working for me to handle the contracts that had come in.
Since that time, they've been able to take a month-long, $10,000 vacation to visit Rosemarie's family in Trinidad. And they've stretched their faith even further through a $10,000 vow.
This took a big step of faith, because I knew in the past that every, you know, pledge we made, we paid on it. $10,000 was a lot. But then God says, you know, he will give seed to the sower, and he will give bread for us to eat, and he will multiply our seed sown. So we just went ahead and did it. I called the Success in Life Ministry, and we pledged. He just moved us into new opportunities, new business opportunities. What's so exciting is that we're able to pour our life into other people. And coming on Bob Tilton's ministry, listening to his teaching and the revelation that God's given him on vowing, it's blessed our lives. It's blessed our lives so much now. It's just a lifestyle to give and to make vows.
Offer unto God thanksgiving, make your vows, pay your vows, and he'll deliver you in the day of trouble.
The bands of oppression are broken in my life. It's not there no more. The bands of poverty is no longer hovering over me. I'm set free. And I believe that when you make vows, that you experience a deliverance in your life. Nothing could change it. And it's only by paying vows beyond your tithes. You know, you pay your tithes, but also you gotta have vows with God. And then it releases the blessings from heaven into your hands, spiritually and financially.
They had the revelation of the wow of the vow. They had the revelation of going into business with God and planting their seed into their need. The woman in 1 Kings 17 was starving to death, not because of lack of food, but because of lack of knowledge. She needed knowledge to feed her faith. Faith comes by hearing information, hearing about Jesus. And when you hear that word, He is the Word. And when you hear that word, it's like food to your soul. It feeds your inner spirit man so that your inner man, oh, glory to God, so your inner man can rise up and walk in the power of God's name, the power of God's word, and you start operating in the faith of God. You have the creative ability of God, the faith of God. Your faith is like a seed, and when you sow your faith, glory to God, God begins to move. You too can go into business with God. Jacob had a revelation. He saw the windows of heaven opened, and he vowed to tithe. He said, God, I'm going to give you my tithe. And when he did, there was a divine transfer from heaven. Jacob's flocks began to multiply, and his life was totally changed, and he became Israel to rule as God's regent king. We'll be back after these announcements. You too can go into business with God. Get our course. Join the club. Take Daniel's 21-day challenge to transform your life in the next 21 days.
We had gotten deeply in debt.
I think that even the best of relationships, though they can endure, there's going to be stress when you have bills more than what you can afford.
And we began to see, hey, wait a minute. Maybe it doesn't have to be like this forever. Vowing, it has changed our lives because, praise God, faith would rise up.
Start living your dream life. Take our 21-day Daniel's Challenge. Time to live and build your dream life course. Organize your life, focus your faith, get your prayers answered. Call me right now at 888-984-8489. Learn to pay your bills supernaturally. Become debt-free. Start making money. Get all aboard. Become one of our affiliated marketing ambassadors with financial compensation. Now go online or call 888-984-8489. Invest in your future and become one of God's millionaires in the making. Like Jacob, take God as your senior business partner and vow your pledge vow and become part owner with us in our faith-based business also. Now go online at successinlife.club or call me right now at 888-984-8489. That beautiful couple whose testimonial you just watched, they had a revelation. They realized that they could make a vow of faith to God. They vowed $100, which was a lot of faith, and then they vowed $1,000, and that was by faith. They turned their faith into seed, and they begin to work with God, and God began to work with them. This woman in 1 Kings 17 was starving to death. Her and her son were about to eat their last meal and die. But God sent a prophet to her. The prophet had said, that woman is going to supply your need. And he knew that God would supply her need as she sowed her seed out of her need, out of her want, into the Word of God. The prophet said, what do you have? She said, I just have a little oil, a little meal. I'm making my last meal. I'm going to pay my bills. I'm going to die. He said, before you do that, make me a little cake first. He was teaching her, basically, how to prime the pump. So many people don't prime the pump. Remember the story about the pump and a little bucket of water? You could drink that little bucket of water, or you could pour that water into the pump and begin to pump the pump, and water would begin to come out. So many people are drinking their water. They're drinking what they need to be priming the pump with. The prophet told the woman, make me a cake first. She primed the pump. He knew her seed, like faith, the miraculous would begin to multiply. This couple's faith, their seed, their $12 or whatever it was, began to multiply. They went into business with God. They did something. They got out of the boat. They stepped up and began to use their faith. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. When you begin to hear the Lord talk to you, that woman with the issue of blood, she heard the truth. Faith comes by hearing. She heard. It caused her to get up and to press through the crowd and touch the hem of Jesus' garment. He said, woman, thy faith made you whole. Whole person prosperity. First the spiritual, the mental, the physical, the financial, all seven areas of your life. You need to get our course. You need to, in fact, you can join the club for free trial today. You can take the 21-day challenge today. Daniel had a dream, he had a vision, he had a revelation, and he sought God. He put first the kingdom of God in his life. Jesus said, seek first, before you do anything else, seek first the kingdom of God. Learn to walk in the righteousness of Christ. By the way, if you've never committed your life to Christ and accepted him, why don't you do it right now? Invite him into your heart. Let your sins be forgiven. accept Him as your Lord and Savior, and say it with your mouth, Jesus, you're my Lord. Amen and amen. We'll be back after these announcements with more exciting news, how you too can go into business with God, begin to prosper, take our course, join the club, take Daniel's 21-day challenge, 21 days to change your life, to chart your course by the dream in your heart, begin to run with your vision, help other people get their dreams fulfilled, and God will bless you. Find a need and fill it. Find a hurt and heal it. Find a problem and solve it in the mighty name, using the name of Jesus. We'll be right back.
Our self-image was, deteriorated bad. We didn't believe, wow, could we ever get to zero?
He will give seed to the sower, He will give bread for us to eat, and He will multiply our seed. So
offer unto God thanksgiving, make your vows, pay your vows, and He'll deliver you in the day of trouble.
The bands of poverty is no longer hovering over me. I'm set free. You gotta have vows with God, and then it releases the blessings from heaven into your hands, spiritually and financially.
Start living your dream life. Take our 21-day Daniel's Challenge. Time to live and build your dream life course. Organize your life, focus your faith, get your prayers answered. Call me right now at 888-984-8489. Learn to pay your bills supernaturally. Become debt-free. Start making money. Get all aboard. Become one of our affiliated marketing ambassadors with financial compensation. Now go online or call 888-984-8489. Invest in your future and become one of God's millionaires in the making. Like Jacob, take God as your senior business partner and vow your pledge vow and become part owner with us in our faith-based business also. Now go online at successinlife.club or call me right now at 888-984-8489. So there are riches in glory, Philippians 4:19, but my God will supply all of your need according to His riches in glory. There are riches in heaven. It's the wealth of heaven. It says through Jesus Christ, through the power of Christ, through the power of righteousness, through the power of walking in His name. Glory to God. Jesus said it like this, seek first the kingdom of God. He said, don't store up riches on earth where rust and moth corrupt and thieves break forth and steal, but store up riches in heaven. Where your treasure is, where your heart is where your treasure is. Jesus is saying, seek before you do anything else, before you do anything else, seek first the kingdom of God. Learn to walk in the righteousness of God, the dominion of God, the authority of God. And then He said these things, all these things that you need will be added unto you. He said, look how He takes care of the little birds and the lilies, and the flowers and the grass. He says, they don't sow, we do sow. They don't reap, we do reap. They don't store in barns, we store in barns, but yet your Father taketh good care of them. How much more is He going to take care of you? And by the way, everything God has is yours. The prodigal son's brother didn't know that his inheritance was there. Unclaimed riches, unclaimed inheritance. You have to use your faith to draw out of your heavenly account. This woman right here was starving to death, 1 Kings 17, not because of lack of food, but because of lack of knowledge. And the prophet began to speak the word of God, the word of the Lord to her. She heard it, and she said she went and did according to the saying of Elijah, and she and he and her house ate for many days. Why? Because she heard the word, faith came, she acted upon it. Instead of eating her seed, she sowed her seed and her seed began to multiply. Jesus said it like this, if you will put God first and not trust in what you have and start trusting in what God has, you can have up to 100 times as much more. He said, how hard it is for those who trust in what they have, their riches, But when we let go of what we have, we begin to sow our seed, we begin to prime the pump, and water begins to come out. Glory to God. We're learning how to walk in the victory, walk in our inheritance with this divine, I can't say it enough, there's a divine transfer going on out of the hands of the unrighteous into the hands of the righteous. Now, go into business with God. Take our 21-day Daniel's challenge for your life to be changed. Get all aboard. Learn how to vow the vow of faith. God, who gives seed to the sower, will also give you bread to eat and will multiply your seed sown. Glory to God. He which soweth sparingly will reap sparingly, but he which soweth bountifully will reap bountifully. 2 Corinthians 9:8. Now here's my announcer. Get ready to sow your seed. Call us right now. Don't just sit there. Get up and do something with your life. Make your vow of faith. Get all aboard. Join the club. By the way, we have ministerial compensation for those of you that go into business with God. We'll be right back.
The bands of poverty is no longer hovering over me. I'm set free. And I believe that when you make vows, that you experience a deliverance in your life. Nothing could change it. And it's only by paying vows beyond your tithes. You know, you pay your tithes, but also you got to have vows with God. And then it releases the blessings from heaven into your hands, spiritually and financially.
Start living your dream life. Take our 21-day Daniel's Challenge. Time to live and build your dream life course. Organize your life. Focus your faith, get your prayers answered. Call me right now at 888-984-8489. Learn to pay your bills supernaturally. Become debt-free. Start making money. Get all aboard. Become one of our affiliated marketing ambassadors with financial compensation. Now go online or call 888-984-8489. Invest in your future and become one of God's millionaires in the making. Like Jacob, take God as your senior business partner and vow your pledge vow and become part owner with us in our faith-based business also. Now go online at successinlife.club or call me right now at 888-984-8489. That woman was not perishing because of lack of food or money. She was perishing because of lack of knowledge. I'm not talking about natural knowledge. I'm talking about supernatural knowledge. I'm talking about the Word of God, Jesus. I'm talking about faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. Why? Because he that comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those that diligently seek him. Here in 2 Kings, the 4th chapter, a woman was crying out with great travail because the creditors were coming to take her sons away because of debt. They were slaves to debt. And she didn't know what to do, but she asked the prophet who would speak the word of the Lord, who would preach the promises of God, who would speak by the authority of God. And she cried out to him. The creditors were coming. He says, "What can I do for you? What's your problem? What's your need? Where's your hurt? My success is based upon you being successful. And your success is based upon you being successful by helping others be blessed." Listen to this. This is a powerful revelation. We're talking about going into business with God. We're talking about not eating your seed and having a revelation that God gives you seed to sow. It's your faith. You make a faith vow, a faith pledge, like Jacob. He had a revelation that heaven was open. He saw the blessings of God coming down through the angels of God. He awakened from his slumber, his sleep. Are you waking up yet? And he realized that where he was the house of God. When you wake up and realize God lives on the inside of you, there's a gold mine on the inside of you. Jesus told Peter, go fishing, cast a hook, cast your faith out there, cast your seed out there on the waters, and you will find it again after many days. Yay. Oh, yes, Peter cast out and caught a fish. And Jesus said, the first fish you catch, open its mouth and get the money out. There's money in your mouth. There's riches on the inside of you. His riches in glory. Accepting Christ is accepting forgiveness. It's accepting your inheritance. It's rising up and walking in His ability and going into the promised land and possessing your inheritance. Unclaimed wealth, unclaimed inheritance. You're a beneficiary from the benefactor. And there are benefits and blessings from heaven when you accept Christ and accept Abraham's seed, which is Jesus. You become redeemed from the curses and moved and blessed into the blessings of Abraham. You become the head and not the tail, above and not beneath, and a lender and not a borrower. Glory to God. We're walking into our inheritance. You have to rise up, but you have to possess it. You have to seize the moment. That's why you need to call me right now. We're here standing by myself or our associates. You can join the club. You can make your vow. You can go into business with God. Take Daniel's 21-day challenge. Why sit there till you die? Those four lepers were sitting there. The city was starving to death. They said, if we go back, we'll die. We stay where we are, we'll die. But if we get up and go forward, and when they did, God caused the enemy to flee. It took them, they went into the enemy's camp and great possessions, silver and gold and raiment. They began to prosper, and they said, we need to go back and tell the king's household the glad tidings, the good news. We're redeemed from the curse. We're rising up and walking into our inheritance, an heir of God and a joint heir with Jesus. Glory to God. And the woman cried to the prophet, and the prophet said, what do you have? She said, some oil. He said, begin to fill empty vessels. Have your sons bring empty vessels. Fill empty lives. Thirsty people, hurting people. And when she did, it says that he said, now go sell the oil. Have your sons go out there and sell that miracle oil, that miracle message. And when they did, he said, pay your bills and live off the rest. Debt-free living. Call me right now. Don't sit there another second. At least call. Get their 21-day challenge. It's free. Begin to rise up. Begin to take our course. Make your pledge. Go into business with God. If you mean business with God, you've got to cast out there. You've got to let go of what you have in order to walk into the abundance of life that God has. It's all scriptural. It's all in the Bible. It's just a matter of you believing it and doing something with your life. You've got to let go in order to receive everything that God has. Now, here's my announcer, and get ready to get blessed.
Thank you for watching the new Success in Life broadcast. Now, like the four lepers, don't sit there till you die. Get up and get going into the big life that God has for you. You are co-creators with God. Seize the moment. Go online to our website, successinlife.club, for your introductory lesson on how to build and live your dream life today. Join and enroll in the new Success in Life Club, or you can call for more info, 888-984-8489. Go to the More Info on Success in Life extension. Rise up and walk into the big life that God has for you.